letter ever get to you?
Before then, sometimes. You know, but never during. Just sitting there trying to figure out how we can score.
Speaking that, you went, I don't know if you know, you went 10 minutes without a field goal in the second half and in the overtime. How did they eventually get it back?
Well, we really didn't, shoot the ball well the whole game. JC made some shots, but I thought Dax had a shot well and shoot around. I thought he would have a good night. He ends up 5 for 7, I guess, but he didn't miss some open shots. They made every open shot in my mind. They really shot the ball well.
Except for the second overtime.
Yeah.
Was that defense or were their legs going?
I think we did a better job of staying in front of them. You know, in overtime, we get up and then we get up guard. Hard to imagine what goes through some of our guys' heads sometimes. We got a potential shot clock violation. Got a guy picked up his dribble in the corner and we fouled. That's just hard to understand why you would do that. Why would you even think to try? I thought that was a big one. Then we just turned it loose twice for layups. I had Beetle in to hopefully make free throws, and of course he falls down, turns it over, and then goes down a straight line drive him in about 5 seconds. So that brilliant coaching move didn't work out very well.
Can you talk about the resiliency of your team after that loss Monday night, coming back to win today?
I personally, and I tell them, you know, I'm angry. It's not going to go away for a while with what happened like that. We gave one away that we should have given away. But we've done that. This team has done that.
Today's game was similar at 2:45, and you gave up the tying score, put it in overtime. You not subscribe to the theory to foul somebody, or you just, I mean, Javon had good defense on the guy, but he makes the three, seven to overtime.
I think if you have the chance to lose, if you foul, the worst was going to happen was they were going to tie the game. They go make one, miss one on purpose. Everybody's got to play. Then they get it and you foul them, you can lose. And I've always said, you know, I always thought we were pretty good defensively. That was a hard shot. He's not going to make it. He made it that one. He's not going to make real high percentage of those.
Coach, it seemed like your rotations in the second half were much maybe shorter or than usual by design, or was the situation of the game?
What substitutions?
Yeah.
Well, Issa was cramping, so it was hard to get him in many minutes. We had some guys went in and did play real well. It's like I tell him all the time, Justin, you want to play more, play better. I was at Akron there. The guy was a starting point guard here before came in and said, you know, coach, he said, can I talk to you? I said, sure. I said, what's up? He said, well, don't take this the wrong way, but, you know, I think if you were more positive, I could play better. And I said, well, if you were a better player, I'd be a hell of a lot more positive. You know, that goes both ways.
was the one three.
His game today, 17 points, 12 rebounds. I mean, how big is that at this juncture in the season? Teams now knowing you have that inside presence. If you can, you
know, well, like that. I think that's the Elijah Macon that everybody thought we got one more through. He was a very heavily recruited guy. It's just, you know, his attitude has been just so much better. Extremely coachable. He's kind of bought in more to trying to understand, not just play basketball, but understand basketball. And so, I mean, we were supposed to run a back cut when they started staring at the ball. It wasn't supposed to be him, but you know, I mean, he back cut the guy, hooked over the man length. You know, I mean, he's listening. Yeah. I'd like to get him to teach a couple of those other guys to do that. Yes.
Is the 1-3-1 something that you thought would work well against Tech, or something that it's time for you to see and have as a weapon?
Texas plays 1-3-1. I'm watching their game against Texas, and I thought it slowed them down. I told Larry, I think this will work. At least we can buy some time.
Coach, what's preparation going to be like in the next day and a half for Texas with a quick turnaround?
We'll be in here at 4 o'clock tomorrow with them and go through, can't do a whole lot. Go through what we need to do. Texas really bothered us because they've got such great size. Their size and athleticism bothers.
Coach, the obviously what happened in the Kansas game, this game, double overtime, mentally draining. Is that
for
something?
Me?
Well, for you, for the players, for everyone. I mean, is there anything to worry about at this point in the season?
Well, I'm angry. I'm not drained. I'm angry. I'm angry that happened. That's what gave them Tuesday and Wednesday off, and we came back Thursday. That's exactly what I told them. And I thought for a brief period there, we played angry. And we just said, you know, I don't get the ball in bounds. And obviously, that was really the turning point in the second half for a while.
Naeem Stevenson had 17 points in the first half and he went scoreless the rest of the game. Was that an adjustment or was that something about?
No, we just decided we'd probably got a guard. We didn't guard in the first half. We just go to sleep sometimes. I mean, it's like you sit there and you can't just say, I can't believe he's doing this. It's amazing. Let people just straight line drive us to the goal 2 times in a row. I put Beetle in, like I said, to make some free throws, and he falls down, loses the ball, and then he goes down and gets straight line drove. You know. So, what's the difference between him falling down or Dax missing 2 free throws? He's back to the baseline guard.
Megan strikes me as a kind of a sensitive, introspective kid. How do you handle him, and how do you look at him? I mean, has that held him back, or?
Well, Bob, he came down here for a camp when he was a sophomore. And I called him on the way home. So he's going back to Columbus, and I'm like, listen, man, we really want to have you here. And he said, look, I want to be there. So he committed to us. Sophomore. And then we went to Hopkins Prep. We went to Brewster. So we've been with Elijah for a long time. And I spent more time with Elijah probably than I Bell. She's a sophomore. Sophomore has 1, 2, 3, 4. She's been here 4 years. That's 8 years with her. That's a lot. That's a lot. So.
When I was married.
Could the offensive putbacks by Dax, how?
Well, we've been trying to get him to do it. He's the self-proclaimed best athlete on the team. And we've been trying to get him to rebound it offensively. It's hard to rebound it defensively when as soon as they let it go, you run the other way, which frequently is. But there's no reason why he shouldn't be able to rebound.
Anything else? Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.